Hey, beautiful friends, it's Catherine from Sacred Heart Alchemy. So I wasn't planning on jumping on, but I had some time open up and I thought I'd take the opportunity to just come on and see how everybody's doing. The energies have been really kind of wonky and crazy. And so I know I've been feeling it myself. You know, as I talk with people during the week, seeing clients and, you know, even just people in general, as I'm doing my own classes where more information about what's going on, you know, sort of galactically and cosmically is being shared all the time. I wanted to just jump on, particularly for those of you who are maybe feeling this really powerful energy that's been going on, and particularly in the last couple of weeks. I know I've been saying this for like 20 years, but the truth is that the energy keeps accelerating and keeps, you know, it as though it's trying to move us through the eye of a needle, right? So it becomes more intense, it becomes more pressured. We're having more solar flares, we're having more sunstorms. All of that is going on. The photon light energy is really high. And what happens then is that everything that's been in the dark, whether it's within your own shadow, something that you have pushed into your own subconscious, something that you have sort of disowned about yourself, something that you were shamed about, anything that you don't sort of like the world to see, or that you may not want to look at yourself, is really being forced up to the surface right now. So if you have had experiences of things that you thought you had healed in the past, or at least dealt with and, you know, kind of put it back on the shelf, if that's coming back around again, just know that it's an invitation from the universe to say, hey, there's a little more that needs, or maybe a lot more that needs your attention here. This has not been resolved. It is still unhealed. And we are in this phenomena right now, which I'm going to go into a little more detail in a few minutes, where the entire power, support, love, energy of the universe is helping to sweep these things up into your awareness so that it can be revealed and then healed. Because until something comes out into the light, until we have an awareness that it's even at play in our system, in our you know, cellular memory, in parts of our brain where we have stored things that have been frightening or that we felt as a threat to our own survival, until we actually have the light shown on those things so that we can bring them forward, they are unavailable really to be healed, right? They're still in the dark, they're still in the shadow. So I mostly want you to know that if things are coming up and you're like, what the bleep is going on here? Just know that everything in the universe is supporting the timing of this. And that it's not because you haven't done it right before. It's not because you're being punished. It's not because you had one errant thought and now the universe is, you know, backhanding you. It's none of those things. It is really the universe through love saying, dear one, it's time to let go of these patterns. It's time to let go of these programs. It's time to break the chains of the things that have kept you in bondage for this lifetime and, you know, more likely than not, many lifetimes. Right? These, we're not just healing that which we know about in this lifetime. We're healing things that have been pushed into our subconscious, repressed, that's coming up. But we're also, as we heal ourselves, because everything is happening in this present moment, we're actually healing our lineage. We're healing our ancestry going backwards, and we're clearing energy and healing going forward, so that our lineage, right, is not having to deal with and address the things that we are finally bringing to the surface in this lifetime. And just say hi to everybody who's here. Hey, Tina. Hey, Laura, Janice, PJ, nice to see you. And so just know that everything is literally happening in divine order, even though it may seem like it's totally out of control. I know even for myself, you know, I've been dropping things, and I'm just being really careful when I'm taking steps so that I don't go tumbling down the stairs, or my brain has just been really foggy. I also had this, this is always a time of year where I'm thinking about my mom, because the anniversary of her passing 45 years ago, which blows my mind, was this week. And it falls right between my grandson's birthday, who of course never had an opportunity to meet her, my kids never had an opportunity to meet her, and Mother's Day. So this is a very powerful sort of period of the year for me. You know, as it comes to the end of the school year, it was my final day of college classes was the day that my mom passed. And so it's sort of, you know, that marks that time in my mind. And whenever this time of year comes up, spring and the end of, you know, school semesters and Mother's Day, that's always very present for me. So just know that whatever is coming up, PJ, you may remember this. Ina said something the other day, you know, whatever is showing up in your life right now, like today, yesterday, this morning, is what is coming up to be healed. So again, just know that you've done nothing wrong. You haven't messed up. It's really the universe supporting you to release the things from the past that are no longer serving you, and to step into your full sovereignty. So I just want to share, and I'm going to turn my head and read a little bit, because I am sort of cherry picking from a number of different people's information, because I am not an astrologer. I don't know the ins and outs of all of these things, but I read people like Meg Benedicti and Sabrina from Rewilding, and even my own teachers, Ina Lucas and Janet Raftis, and, you know, other people who write about these astrological events with much greater understanding and detail than I do. But I love to share what I'm finding out with everybody else, because, you know, if it affects one of us, it affects all of us. And I see the same patterns coming up with clients. And in these last few weeks, and I'll talk about this. So, you know, 2 weeks ago, we had a new moon solar eclipse on April 20th. And then 2 weeks later, today, May 5th, which is also the start of the actual start of Beltane, we will have a full moon lunar eclipse. If you notice the date today, the date is 5/5, and then if you just do the last two digits, 23. So I don't know, maybe that's cheating a little bit, not using the 2023, the full thing, but we're looking at a 5/5/5 date. Five in terms of just numbers and the energy that they bring is about change. So 5/5/5 is kind of like strap up, right? When we see triple and quadruple digits, five, it really means there's a lot of change in the air. So there is a massive collective shift happening in humanity, right? even though it is very crazy on the surface, all the things we're seeing in politics, in education, in the banking system, right? All of the systems, all of the institutions that have been built on this patriarchal foundation of greed and power over and suppression of the feminine and emotions and our intuition, we're seeing all of that crumble. And I have said this before, but it's coming up, so I'm just going to repeat it. You know, when I got serious sort of on my spiritual path 25 or so years ago, I kept hearing that we were going to come to a point in time when all of our systems were going to collapse, and that would have to happen in order for something new to be born, right? Like the phoenix rising from the ashes, which is exactly the energy that we're in right now. And it was like, how the heck is that going to happen? How can all of our systems collapse at the same time and to allow something new to be born, right? And then, you know, somewhere in the middle of COVID, I went, could have had a V8. Guess what's happening right now? All of our systems are falling apart so that something new can be born. And so obviously it's not an overnight thing. We're seeing this roll out and we're in the middle of it and it looks like crazy. And I know for me, I can go down the rabbit hole of that and get really caught up in all that negativity and all of the stuff that's going on politically. And I really have to be very careful with what I'm paying attention to and giving my energy to, or, you know, it can kind of take me out. So let me go back. I'm going to, as I said, sort of look over this way a little bit because I have some notes. So again, today, 555 date, May 5th, 2025. Today we have a full moon it's the full moon in Wesak, and it's also a lunar eclipse. So we're winding up this 2-week eclipse cycle. Eclipses happen in 2-week cycles. There's, you know, a solar eclipse and a lunar eclipse. So this full moon is going to be in Scorpio, which again doesn't mean a lot to me, except that it's all about liberation energy. The incoming energies are really saturating this eclipse corridor as we move into this full moon this afternoon. There's been an increase in solar flares, sun storms, in addition to these different alignments. So this particular lunar eclipse in Scorpio is happening what's called on the south node, which is all about the past. So this new moon, full moons are always about releasing. So this full moon is about, it's a big one. It's about releasing the burdens, not only in our own lives, but of our ancestors and our past lives, right? All the wounding that we hold in our genetics, in our DNA, all of our cellular memory, the things we have not processed through in this lifetime, or again, our own past lifetimes, where things that we've shoved into the shadow, pushed into the subconscious as a way to survive and keep moving, right? This is the time that all of that is coming up. I know 2 weeks ago when we were in the solar eclipse, we talked about the alignment of that being a 19-year cycle. So when I looked back to 19 years, what I was doing in 2004 and what has changed in my life in these 19 years, it was kind of mind-blowing. And I wrote about that. I won't go into all the details, but 2004 was, you know, I left the therapy practice I was in. I went, started a 2-year seminary program that I was ordained in 2 years later. I left my job. I opened a healing center. And then shortly after that, left a 30-year marriage, all my financial security, my kids, my home, my dogs, like my whole life, literally starting in 2004, turned inside out and upside down. And so this cycle is bringing us into another 19-year cycle. So it's not like, oh, what do you want to create, you know, in this next moon cycle? We're literally talking about 19-year cycle at play here. So again, this eclipse is on the south node, all about ancestral lineage, genetics, what's held in our DNA, there's enormous support for releasing karmic patterns, right, that have plagued us all of our lives and all of our lifetimes. Some people say at a certain point in time, I think it was 2012, anyone who came in after that date came in without the karmic ties, but for those of us who stepped in earlier, there may be still be karma to clear. So what are you carrying, right? What feels heavy for you? What's in that karmic backpack? You know, if you were going on a hike, what would be holding you back in your backpack today? And it's not just that you want to clear this out to get rid of it. It's that you want to literally unpack it with love and care and look at everything you've been through, through a new set of eyes, through eyes of love, through eyes of compassion, through eyes of acceptance and understanding that the things that happened to you, A, were not your fault. They don't make you a terrible person. It doesn't mean you're broken beyond repair. It simply means your soul chose a particular path to walk through in this lifetime. So for me, I call myself an emotional archaeologist or alchemist. I love helping people uncover sort of what seems to be the open or the broken things in the archaeology field, right? And then telling the stories about them and dusting them off and really looking at them for the beauty and the wisdom and the understanding that's held there, for the bravery and the courage and the perseverance to move through really difficult life circumstances. And then we can begin to tell a new story, right, of courage and perseverance and how that particular path may have molded you in a way that now allows you to bring your greater gifts into the world, right? So all of this is possible now in this very powerful energy field that we're in. It's not just about, oh, I gotta pull this stuff up and look at it again. It's, wow, here's an opportunity to look at this again through a different set of eyes, through spiritual eyes, through the eyes of understanding. So keeping that in mind, nobody's being punished. This isn't a cruel joke. It is an opportunity to clear those patterns, ditch those programs, right, and step into your sovereignty. We also have the sun in Taurus, and this is all about embodiment, listening to your gut, paying attention to your intuition, noticing physical misalignments that might have a message for you. I did a very powerful session, actually a couple this week, with clients who all of a sudden had some kind of illness or, you know, something come up. And when we dropped in and paid attention and listened to what was underneath that manifestation, there was always an invitation to heal something. And it was, you know, the unhealed aspect was being brought forward through the body. You know, the body gets our attention in certain ways, but it's not always just about doing the mechanical fixing of it. It's about healing the underlying toxicity or trauma or wound, right? So then it can be released from the body. So where we are in that energy as well, we have two planets in retrograde, Mercury, which, as we know, we've talked about before, when Mercury goes into retrograde, things slow down, or there's an appearance of things slowing down. It's because we're going inward and we're doing all the R things. We're reviewing, remembering, realigning, reevaluating, reexamining, right? We are returning, right? And looking at these patterns and programs to see, again, what's ready to be released and let go. So this Mercury in retrograde energy can sometimes feel frustrating because we're so used to moving so fast, and it's inviting us to slow down and take time to go inward again, to do that review, that reevaluation, And you may find yourself, this is why I think I'm being very careful even as I go up and down stairs. You know, I don't want to be moving too fast for the energy. And, you know, you see people tripping, falling, hurting a leg, breaking a bone in their foot. When we are trying to move too fast through this Mercury in retrograde period. We also just had Pluto move into retrograde, and Pluto always wants us to go deep. There's, again, I don't understand all the energy of the planets, but Pluto energy is really about diving in deep. So as Pluto goes into retrograde, we're, right, still in that re-examine, realign, redefine, revisit, reevaluate energy. But now it's on a much bigger scale, right? It is our personal issues, but we're also looking at the power plays that are going on in the world, power dynamics, stepping into your authentic empowerment, right? Your own divine sacred power. So Pluto, you know, has this big energy to it. So we'll be seeing, and we are seeing, if you even catch a snippet of news, all the ways in which power has been misused. There's a lot coming up to the surface right now. Think Supreme Court. That's all I'm going to say about that. Couple of other quick things. Pluto and Jupiter are square to each other, and that basically means that they're shining the light on the underworld, right? Going into places where we have not gone before, you know, sort of the Star Trek, right? We're going to go to worlds that we haven't explored before. Phoenix is the death, Pluto is the death and rebirth of the Phoenix energy. And Jupiter is very expansive and transformational. So again, without getting caught in the weeds, we are looking at huge, seeing what's coming up in the shadow, opportunities for transformation, the Phoenix rising. And then finally, the dark goddess, Eris, the goddess of chaos and discord, the advocate and truth teller, I think I must have some of her energy in me, is also being expanded by Jupiter. So again, this goddess energy is about looking at what's being swept under the carpet, right? She wants you to shine your light in the world. She wants you to be a truth teller. She wants you to shine your light. She wants you to advocate for yourself, for humanity. So that requires paying attention to anything that gets in the way of you stepping more into your divine feminine sovereign power, right? Yeah, so there's a lot going on. If you're struggling, I just really invite you to be so loving, so patient, so understanding of whatever process you're in right now. If you have access to any kind of inner child meditations, guided imageries, I would really invite you to spend some time with your younger parts who may be feeling quite disoriented, who might be wanting to leave, right, to kind of dissociate. If memories are coming up that are particularly painful, I know I've been going through this with many clients this week. So really honoring all the parts of yourself that might be feeling afraid, terrified actually, or even rageful, if you haven't tapped into your anger and your rage about things that may have happened to you, you may find yourself, you know, having bursts of anger or outbursts. And, you know, I like to say this is like when the pressure cooker, you know, just gets up to the top and it is no place, the energy, the pressure has no place else to go, it's gonna spew, right? And so some of you might be feeling some of that. as a way to release some of this energy, if you aren't consciously looking for other ways, whether it's moving your body, whether it's getting out in nature, whether it's journaling, whether it's tapping, you know, whatever it may be. I took a, you know, beautiful bath the other night because my body was so achy, and I've been not pushing, well, pushing myself a little bit, but at the end of the day, even if I'm feeling a little tired, I've been going out for a walk just to get my energy moving again. So nothing extreme. Your pressure cooker has been at the top, PJ. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. So whatever tools, whatever, you know, this is all about, I don't want to say managing, regulating your central nervous system, because as all of these things get stirred up, so will the emotions, the belief systems, the energies, right, that were present when these things occurred or when they got pushed into your subconscious because they were, you know, too difficult for perhaps for a child to process. So really, you know, lean into all the tools that you have at your fingertips, whether you have them yourself specifically, or whether you go to YouTube and find a inner child meditation or a tapping sequence. There are many, many, many resources out there that are available. If you need, you know, more, you know, one-on-one support, please feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to touch base. And anyway, I hope that helps. To let you know that it's not just you, that you're not just, you know, feeling wonky or out of sorts or spacey or off balance or exhausted for no reason. There's lots of reasons. So take good care, practice self-care, practice self-love, be the kind voice in your own head that lets you know it's okay, we've got this, we're just releasing the stuff that's not serving us anymore, hasn't been serving us for a long time, but is finally ready to be released, because if it's coming up, it's ready to go. So, my loves, that's it for today. Happy full moon, happy eclipse, happy Wesak, happy 555, all the things, even happy retrogrades, and we'll see you again soon. All right, namaste.